everybody who knows me knows that I have an infatuation with Haitian men. I love Haitian men with every fiber of my soul. Haitian men are what I love. Haitian men are my weakness. But some of y'all be having me fucked up. Pause the video right now. Right now. One, smash that subscribe button. Two, like this video. Three, go get some snacks, bruh. Like, I already ate, so I'm good. But go get some snacks, you know. I'll be right here. See, that every time you see that intro, whatever, you're supposed to go get some snacks. See, that's supposed to give you the time to go get your snacks. But, you know, I know some of y'all don't be listening or whatever. So, we just gonna give you some time right now, feel me? Because they assumed that I was talking shit about Jamaican men and saying that I was disrespecting the culture when honestly all I was doing was telling my story. I just didn't like the vibe that I got from them when I was dating them and they got physical with me, like legit, like one of them legit tried to put their hands on me and I was not having it. And yeah, maybe if a Haitian man tries to put his hands on me, I'm be like, nah, fuck Haitian niggas. I mean, I guess I'd rather stick to the ancientness that I know, which is Haitian men, and I'm Haitian, therefore I want to date niggas that are like me. I want to date someone who's like me and shares the same culture as me. Not to say that I will discriminate from any other race. I will date anything that I like. If someone likes me and they treat me correctly and I like them and the feelings are reciprocated, then I have absolutely no problem with dating anyone outside of the Haitian community. However, I prefer my Haitian men, okay? I am not talking about all type of men from the Caribbean, all types of men anywhere. This is legit my experience with some Haitian men. Now, usually I predominantly date Haitian men. These are the funniest situations that's ever happened to me. I always used to get caught up in these type of situations like way back, and I just thought it would be a funny story. I am in no way, shape, or form bashing Haitian men or any men. I'm not bashing anyone. I am strictly saying my experience. Y'all know I love my Haitian men, but y'all be crazy. Okay, y'all be crazy. Therefore, I'm going to say this the same way I said it in that video. I am not trying to say all Haitian men are like this. I am not trying to say all Caribbean men are like this. I'm not trying to say that all Haitian men are bad, because y'all already know I love Haitian men with every fiber of my soul. But I'm saying this is my experiences, that were the terrible experiences that I have had with Haitian men. These type of situations only happen to me when I dated Haitian men. So before anyone comments on this video saying stupid shit, please listen, understand, and comprehend every single thing that I just fucking said. Because what I'm not gonna do is go back and forth with some ignorant people who cannot fucking hear. Anyways. Okay, so this is going to be three mini stories in one video, because I just thought about all of this and I thought about some extra details, and I think I've told all three of these stories on my channels like way back, like probably like a year or so ago. But I was like, we're gonna do this shit over because I remember some shit. Actually, this is two guys that I met at the same wedding, two different situations. So both of these, actually I'm gonna talk about three guys, and three of these guys are very influential in the Haitian community. Therefore, I definitely will not be dropping any names because all these motherfuckers won't be married or whatever, but they was just in my inbox, but that's none of my business. So I don't wanna ruin anybody's marriages, I'm just saying, okay? So we're going to start off with this first guy. So I met this one guy at one of my closest friends' weddings. So this wedding was years ago, like years ago. When I'm telling you years ago, like I don't even remember if I was in college or yet. I probably wasn't in college. It was probably like a freshman in college. It's probably like the summer of my freshman year. I'm not even sure, to be honest with you. And the age doesn't really matter. So I met this guy and I did not give him my number, but he ended up finding me on Facebook after the fact. And I'm telling you, I felt absolutely famous after this wedding. Like, when I'm telling you, niggas was pouring in my DMs, pouring in my friend request box on Facebook after this wedding, it made absolutely no sense. Like, people was hitting me up like crazy. So he kept hitting me up. I was legit ignoring him. And then he came to a point where I was just like, you know what, let me just have a conversation with him. Like, what's the harm? I personally was not interested. I didn't want nothing to do with this bid, but he kept talking to me and I was like, whatever. I mean, it could be a good business connect for the simple fact that he was an influential guy in the Haitian community. So all three of these guys were influential guys in the Haitian community, okay? I'm just gonna let y'all know that right now. But anyways, so this guy sits there and he's just blowing me up. And I'm just like, I don't want nothing to do with him. You know, like when I'm telling you blowing me up, like he's saying some like crazy shit. Like, yeah, I'm trying to be with you. Yeah, I really like you. Why don't you give me a chance? Like all types of shit like that. Like this is real, okay? I really just didn't give a fuck. So it came to a point where, fast forward, I went to a baby shower. And I see him there. And the thing is, I was with my friends. All of my friends know about the situation because I tell my friends mostly everything. So there had to be like 6-7 of us at this table. So it's my table and then like his table's right there. So one of my friends is like, hey yo, like that ain't homeboy that's been blowing up your inbox at that table? Like, oh shit, well, what do you know? And then he got this little chick with him, this little ragamuffin. Now, I'm not calling her a ragamuffin because I'm a hater, because like I said, I did not want this man. I didn't want nothing to do with this man. But she really just looked like a ragamuffin, and I'm gonna call it the way it is. Like, you know how like at a baby shower, you know, you go and you walk up to the person when they're opening your gift and you take a photo with them or whatever the case may be. So it came to the point where they opened his gift and he went to go take a picture with the people that's having a kid. You know, the funny part is I love Haitian people because Haitian people are so mixy and Haitian people are always blowing people's spot up. As he walks up to go take a picture with, you know, the woman that's having the baby or whatever, they're like, oh, shout outs to him, you know, he's about to get married soon. But he was just in my inbox last week. The fuck you mean he about to get married? Boy, I was just like, yo, I was what? My whole table's laughing. Like, look, bro, we made such a scene. We was laughing so hard. We was just like, bruh, are you about to get married? But you was just in my inbox. And my thing is, a lot of you guys are probably like, what the hell? But you didn't talk to him though. That's the point. I didn't talk to him because I was not interested. But if I had actually gave in to that shit, say if I actually like liked him and actually gave in to that and I was actually hanging out with him and doing shit with him or whatever, that would have looked very bad on my part. I probably would have got dragged. How about the girl put fucking hands on me? Like, that's mad dangerous, bruh. Like, that's ridiculous. Like, it's just the fact that, like, you could have really put me in some fucked up shit. So, whatever. We make a scene, we start laughing, and he moves completely, like, across the room from me. Like, that shit was so funny. Like, he moved away. Like, he was like, nah, bro, y'all doing too fucking much. I'm moving away. And I'm like, yeah, bitch, you better go. So I continue to be more petty. I don't give a shit because, like, that's just me. Like, I'm petty. So I just keep laughing. And we were sitting there like, about a week ago. Because, you know, at the time, that was the song. So we was like, yes, a week ago. About a week ago. Hey, a week ago. About a week ago. Yo, we were fucking shit up. Eventually, they left early because they was mad as fuck. But that shit was just very, 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 very funny. In that situation, I didn't get caught up. But these next two situations, I'm telling you. So next situation, I met this guy at the same wedding. Except with this one, I actually gave him my number. I have no idea why. I think I found him more cute and more attractive of some sort. I'm not sure why I gave him my number, but I actually gave this one my number. And I'm talking to him. We're texting, but I was absolutely not interested in him either, honestly. Like, I was only just interested in being his friend because, again, he was influential in the Haitian community, and it's always good to have connects and expand your horizons. So I was talking to him, we were texting. If I like you, you're going to know. If I want you, you're going to know. I'm a very transparent individual. But on his side, it was different. He was trying to get with me, he was talking about something, I really like you, let me take you out, let me buy you shit. And I was like, you don't need to buy me anything, but like, we can go out places, you know. So like, we went to the mall, we went out to eat a couple times, and every single time we went to the mall, every time we went out to eat, I paid for my own shit. He didn't like that. But see, I bought him inside. No. He did not like that at all. He did not like the fact that I was not letting him pay for my shit. But the way I saw it, it was just like, listen, like, I'm not interested in you in that way, and I don't want you to get the wrong idea. You see how like, I wised up so much since I was in high school. Like, I wised up a lot. But anyways, I was just like, yeah, like, to be honest, I don't want you to buy me anything. I could pay for it myself. Like, honestly, like, you're good. But I'm telling you, this man would get pissed. Like, he was pissed. Like, about to throw a whole tantrum in public. Pissed. Like, I don't know what you're mad about, but whatever. So one day we ended up going to his house, right? So this guy is, again, one of the most, he's a very influential person in the Haitian community, and he makes music. He has like a little in-home studio thing. I'm not sure why we went back to his house. I think he had to go get something, and then we just ended up just staying there. So I was on the couch, like literally I was on the couch, and he was like on the computer. We were nowhere like doing nothing or anything like that. And I start seeing photos. I started seeing photos of this girl all over the apartment, right? I was like, who's this girl that's like all over your, like, you know, apartment? He's like, oh no, I live with my sister. And I'm like, oh, okay. I don't know why, I just didn't believe it. That was my, I don't believe it at all. I was like, where is she? He's like, oh no, she's at work, da 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 da. But she's never really here. Usually I have the house to myself. I'm like, okay, whatever, right? One day, I think it was like the same day after that, I got a text from the person's wedding whom I went to where I met him at. So he texted me and he's like, listen, like, I know that, you know, you probably like this dude or whatever. And I was like, correction, I have no interest in this man. This man has interest in me, okay? And he was like, oh, okay, well, just to let you know, he got married. And you could see all the photos on this photographer's page. Now, this photographer is someone that I fuck with. Like, I know him, and he has done numerous pictures for me, as well as pictures for, like, a lot of the different organizations that I'm a part of. And this photographer legit puts photos of everything on his Facebook. Let me tell you, everything. Every single thing, every single event that he goes to and he takes pictures at, he drops them all on Facebook. And he's like, yeah, go check out this guy's wedding photos on this photographer's page. I was like, bruh. I go Facebook. I type in the photographer's page. I had to scroll a good amount because this wedding was a long time ago, and this photographer goes to a lot of events, and like I said, he throws all the pictures on there. So I had to scroll. I scrolled. Saw this man's wedding pictures. And guess who's in the wedding pictures? Same girl that I saw in his house, in his pictures. Bruh. I'm sitting there like, yo, when I tell you, I was laughing. I was like, yo, this man is ridiculous. First of all, I don't want nothing to do with you. I'm not even trying to be with you on no type of romantic level, but you're lying to me. You don't have a girl, you don't have a girlfriend, you don't have a main piece, you don't have a side piece, you don't have anything, but you got a whole wife. Been married to her for like 2 months before he started doing, not even 2 months. I met him like legit a week or two after his wedding, and I found out months after. But it's just like, bro, like, you just got married and you're already fucking up. And again, even though I didn't do anything with him, it's just like, what if I did? What if I was interested? What if, like, I actually fell for all of that nonsense? You would think I went off and I did all of that rah-rah-rah. No, see, at this point in my life, I was not about the rah-rah-rah. I don't make scenes. I'm not an actor. I ain't got time for that shit, okay? We just make statements. We don't make movies. I waited for this man hit up. I took hella screenshots of the pictures that I found. As soon as he said hey to me, I was like, oh yeah, I forgot to tell you, congratulations. Dropped all the pictures. He was like, oh whatever. Excuse me, first of all, that's disrespectful. I said congratulations, you said thank you? You mean thank you? Like, I understand you're mad, but thank you? Like, I was sitting there laughing like, yo, like, this man really bad. Like, he never hit me up ever again. I'm sure I was blocked after that because I never heard from him ever again. I actually ended up seeing him years later after the fact, and yeah, I don't even know if he recognized me or not, but he definitely ain't saying nothing to me, thank God, because I would have lit his ass the fuck up and it would have been story time part two, okay? But again, I'm not a fan of this shit. Like, I swear to you, the only time I've ever gotten caught up in any type of situation where someone had like a old fiance or a wife or whatever the case may be, it was a Haitian nigga. I'm just telling you this right now. I'm not saying that all Haitian men do this, but I'm saying, like, in my experience, that's what has happened to me, and that's what I see. And this is not even just me, because it's happened to my friends as well, because we be having conversations about this, and it should just be so fucking funny to me. So this last situation, I absolutely did get caught the fuck up in this one, and I'm so mad, because I really thought that I had it all together, but clearly I did not. So this guy, I met him at a Haitian party that I went to. So I was performing at this Haitian party, which is the only reason I was there. I don't show up to events like that unless I am invited a very long time ago, it is one of my close friends, or if I'm singing, performing, or hosting, or something like that at this event. Other than that, you're not gonna see me go to an event just for the hell of going there, because I feel like I could be doing a lot more things, like filming a fucking video, than sitting at an event. I'm just saying, that's just me, right? So I went to this event because I was performing there, and one of my close friend's brothers was there. And he was with this guy, and this guy was the cutest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. Like, he was so cute, and he was the definition of the type of Haitian men that I like. If you know me, okay, if you've watched my videos before, if you are truly the mafia gang, you know for a fact that I love Haitian men with every fiber of my soul. Especially tall Haitian dark-skinned men. And this man was tall Haitian and dark-skinned. Telling you, it was like love at first sight. It was love at first sight. Like, I was so, like, in love with this man. Like, not in love, but, like, I really was, like, super duper interested in him. You guys should know about me. If I really like you, or I want you, or if I'm strongly interested in you, I'm going to go after you. I'm not a shy person. I have no problem shooting my shot with anybody. And that's what happened. I shoot my shot, okay? Okay, y'all get the fucking point, okay? I went after homeboy. I was talking to him or whatever, and then one of these songs came on, and I swear to God, we danced to like a good couple of songs. And if you are Haitian, or if you listen to Haitian music, you know Haitian songs ain't fucking short, okay? Haitian songs are minimum 6 minutes. So a couple songs means we was probably dancing for a good 15 to 20 minutes minimum, okay? We was fucking shit up, okay? Guya was sweet. Girl, let me make love to you on the dance floor. Girl, let me make love to you on the dance floor. Guya was on a million. I was absolutely like feeling this man, okay? I was like, listen, like, he could be the one, like, yo. Tall, Haitian, dark-skinned, beard, knows how to dance. And again, he was very influential in the Haitian community, and he made music. I like to sing. It would have been great. It was a perfect thing. I'm telling you, man, it would have been perfect if he wasn't a motherfucking dog. Let's get through the story. We ended up kicking or whatever. We were talking, we were texting, we were doing this, that. They're like legit, we were talking all the time. We were talking for a couple of months at this point. And it got to a point where it was just weird. Like, he just stopped talking to me. Like, he would barely hit me up, and when he would hit me up, it would be really slow. I wouldn't see him often, and that started to bother me. I'm one of those people, I don't like people all up in my face every day. I really don't. That's why most of my long-distance relationships usually work a lot better than my short-term ones, because I don't like people all up in my face. If I get married, I don't know what the fuck I'm going to do, because personally, I do not like people being in my fucking face every fucking day. Like, it annoys me. I'm one of those people, I need you to hit me up every day. I need you to call me every day, and I need you to text me every day. If you do not text or call me, I'm going to get mad. I don't need to be in your face, but you're gonna need to hit me the fuck up. Because with him, like, he would barely hit me up, he would barely try to hang out with me, and I was like, you know what, fuck it, like, I don't care, like, I'm not about to sit there and bombard a nigga, I don't have time for that. When you hit me up, you hit me up. So then one day, out of the blue, homeboy hits me up, and he's like, oh man, I'm sorry I haven't been hitting you up, but you know, I got a warrant out for my arrest, because, you know, I have this ticket I didn't pay, and that's why I haven't been seeing you. And I'm like, oh, okay, well, how much is this ticket? Or whatever, and he goes, it's $100, and I'm just like, oh, okay. Now, I didn't know nothing about traffic laws and violations, but I don't know if you could really get locked up for a $100 ticket. And even if that's possible, why the hell is it that you have a job, and then you're part of a Haitian man, and you ain't got $100? Like, that's not that I'm thinking about that now, but at the time, like, that was my boo or whatever, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna give you the $100. Now, at this point, we were dating, Yeah, at this point we were dating. And I'm one of those people, if you are my boyfriend or if you are a very close friend of mine and you really need something, I'm going to give it to you. I do not like to lend, and I do not like to let people borrow anything for the simple fact that I'm one of those people, if I lend you shit, I want that shit back. Okay, like today. So I would rather just give it if I have it and not worry about it. And I gave him the $100 and then I saw him like a few days later. We kicked it or whatever, we were chilling, and then some other BS happened. So while we're chilling, I hear his phone keep going off. I am very agitated by phones ringing. This is why my phone is usually on Do Not Disturb 99.9% of the time. There are times when you can catch my phone not on Do Not Disturb, but I always see my notifications anyway, but my phone is always on Do Not Disturb. I do not like notifications going off. I don't like phones ringing. I don't like that shit. It really, really annoys me. So his phone kept ringing and I'm just like, you're gonna get that or no? Like, are you gonna pick that shit up? I asked him who it was. He said it was his ex that keeps calling him. And I'm just like, oh.
I can see my ex calling. Oh, no, why my ex calling? I don't know why my ex calling. Why the fuck my ex calling?
Like, I don't know why he's avoiding picking up his phone. Like, in my mind, I was like, maybe this nigga got a bitch. Maybe.
Why the fuck my ex calling? I don't know why my ex calling.
Like, alright, so you're just not gonna answer her? Like, I'm like, whatever, I guess. Like, I'm pretty sure that's what he was saying in his mind. Like, oh no, my ex calling, something like that. I knew something was wrong with that, but at the same time, I didn't want to accuse him or anything, and I personally didn't have any proof. And I'm one of those people, I don't make movies. Like I said, I don't make movies, okay? I don't have time for that. I just wanted to know, so that's why I just asked. I didn't make a big deal out of it. So that's what he told me, so whatever, I took it for face value. So a couple of months later, I'm sleeping in my bed, getting my beauty rest, about to get my education because I had to go to school the next day or whatever. All of a sudden, I get these phone calls. When I'm telling you phone calls, like phone calls, like with a Z, bruh. I get at least like 8 phone calls and I'm just like, bro, why is there flying here? The fuck? I get like 8 phone calls from this like unknown number. Like, I don't, the number's not saved in my phone. I'm just like, it's like 2:00 in the morning. Business hours is 12 p.m. to 12 a.m. Do not blow up my phone. Do not call my phone. Do not text my phone anytime after that or before that. Okay, that 12 hour time slot is the only time you can hit me up and expect me to pick up the motherfucking phone. I didn't call the number back, but I get a fucking slew of text messages. Oh, fuck you, bitch. You're a whore. You're a slut. Stop talking to my man. He's my fiance. Oh. Bitch. At this point, I'm just like, okay, like, who's your man, sis? And then she says his name, and I was like, oh. Not about to go back and forth with this girl at this point. I go and I hit him up like, listen, I'm like, yo, like, who's this chick out here claiming you, cursing me out, talking about I'm a hoe and shit, and then you her fiance. He's like, oh no, that's my ex, she's crazy, blah blah blah, that's my ex fiance, my ex this, my ex that. And I'm just like, okay. I didn't know what to say at that point, cause it's like, he was trying to get me back into his life. I broke up with him. I was like, you're not about to have me in this bullshit. Cause Haitian girls is fucking crazy. She gonna fuck around, do voodoo on me, make my hair fall out, make me shorter than I already am. She gonna do some shit to me, and I don't want no parts of that. So I was like, you gotta go. Bruh, he was not playing no games. Honestly, I was over it. And so I was in McDonald's, he met up with me, and we were talking, and he was trying to tell me the same thing. Like, you know, I really wanna be with you, and I really miss you. Like, I love you. It's like, honestly, I don't know who the fuck she, I don't know why she keeps doing this. Like, I love you and she's my ex.
Oh, boo-hoo! Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
To be honest with you, I don't know how you love me when we only been together for a couple months. Love me where, bitch? That's another thing. A lot of these Asian niggas be on that I love you shit way too early for me, and I just be like, bruh, like, you love this dude. It's like, no, let me stop. The point is, it was just like, I honestly, I was just so over it. So it came to a point where I was just like, you know, I guess I'll give you another chance. But I don't think we got back together, but I think we just continued to talk. And then as I'm texting him, lo and behold, the girl comes back again. Stop texting my man. You a fucking hoe. You're a fucking slut. All this shit. I'm like, listen, I'm not done, okay? I'm not about this life. I don't have time for this. I gave up fighting a long time ago. And maybe this girl is actually telling the truth. I don't know. I don't want to know. But all I know is I'm not trying to be caught up in nobody BS. Like, I don't like when people put me in unnecessary situations. And that was absolutely an unnecessary situation. This girl was out here doing the most. Then she started saying that she gonna kill me and she gonna find out where I live. Like, this girl was going crazy. I'm like, listen, the D not that good to be doing all that nonsense. It really isn't. But listen, yeah, that's your bitch. That's your nigga. Listen, you can have him, okay? You can have him. Those are three situations where literally people almost got me caught up and almost made me help them cheat on their fiancés or their wives. I don't even understand what that is to call these people. I still love my Haitian men, however. I still love y'all. But some of y'all literally be having me all the way and be getting me into some crazy ass fucking situations. If you like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. If you didn't, it's okay. You can give it a big thumbs down. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. And I'm gonna see y'all next time.